Tai Chi. Let's start with a basic exercise. The movement you are familiar with is just you sit on the legs as usual. Hang the arms and place them like there is an imaginary table in front of you. So you place the palms on that imaginary table. And now we want to get the arm, the hands at that height, but without folding the shoulder joint. Now imagine a cogwheel inside the shoulder. And you sit, have the hands on the table, and now that cogwheel starts to rotate in this direction, but the hands stay on the table's surface as long as possible. So the elbows are being rotated forward. Make sure you do not move the shoulder. You only want to rotate, have an awareness, a sensation of rotation inside the shoulder. So again, here I sit on my legs, I have my hands stretched out over an imaginary table in front of me. And as usual, soften the back, soften the neck, and so on. You know the drill. And then when you're relaxed, try to search for your shoulder joints from the inside and how they rotate. You're not working on lifting your arms, you're rotating the shoulder joint. At a given moment, while rotating, well, the elbows are going forward, as you can see, the hands are slightly, gliding over the table. You can't keep them like that. So that would be very uncomfortable, and then we would close the wrist joints. We don't want that either. But we're still on the table. So again, sit in a relaxed manner. And then you rotate the shoulder joint forward, the shoulder disc, sorry, in this manner. At a given moment, it will reach its end, and it will be more or less where the palm basis has to leave the table. The fingertips are still on the table. So, sit back, relax, rotate the shoulder disc forward, hands stay flat on the table. Now the hands have to leave the table because there is still some room to rotate with the shoulder disc. So continue to rotate, the palm bases leave the table, palm base, and the fingertips are still on the table. And let go. So rotate the shoulder joint, hands stay flat on the table. I still have room to rotate the shoulder wheel, but then the palm base has to leave the table. And I allow so. And relax. Now, there is no right or wrong in performing this exercise. It's a training method to enhance your sensitivity to, well, your physical insight. The shoulder wheel, the shoulder disc, rotates, moving the arm like that. And at a given moment, fingertips still on the table, palm base has left the table surface, but at the given moment, that shoulder disc will reach its end. It can't rotate any further, and you can play with that, because if you rotate it to the max, palm base has left the table, the only way the shoulder disc can continue to rotate in the same direction is by, well, actually deforming your shoulders. Oh, like that. So then you are not rotating anymore. The rotation has become a follow-up on lifting the shoulder joint. And you do not want to do that. You only want to rotate. Now we're going to add a balance. So the shoulder disc rotates, and then it reaches its end. And then it bounces back. It doesn't shift, it doesn't move forward or backward, it only rotates forward, 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 till the end, and it bounces back. That's all there is to it. This is my okay. So, hands on the surface of the imaginary table, sit through the legs, soften the back, soften the neck, open the hands, sink into the hand, but be aware of the hands on the table, and be aware of the inside of your shoulder joints. Imagine a vertical disc inside that shoulder joint, and that disc starts to rotate forward and forward. It reaches its max unless the palm base goes up a bit. Now I'm at the end, and now I bounce the disc rotation, I bounce it into the other direction. And the hands can leave the table, have to leave the table there. And then just relax the elbows and the hands fall back on the table surface. So you rotate forward with the shoulder disc. Continue, continue, continue. There you reach the end. Bounce back with the disc rotation. Hands leave the table and they move up. And relax. Rotate forward and forward and forward and forward and forward and bounce back. There. Relax the elbows. There. One more in the front view. Rotate forward and forward and forward and forward. Then you reach the end, so bounce back with the rotation. Move backward. There is no end to moving backward. Yes, there is, but we won't get there. Relax the elbows and the hands fall back on the table. So this is step one. Becoming aware of how to stay open and that you do not have to move the arm up. There has to be movement in the arm, with the arm, is not necessary. Just rotate the shoulder disc. That's the important thing. Just rotate the shoulder disc and the hand will get up. Yeah? Now, later on, you will practice to attach the upper arm and the torso to that rotation, so the rotation actually disappears. Well, this sounds complicated, but that's for later. For now, we're going to add the legs to the exercise because I wanted to work on the mechanics of Tai Chi, of course. And now we get to the point where the seven stars name becomes relevant. Like I said, the hands work with the feet, the elbows with the knees, the hips. They are here, of course, not there. The shoulders with the hips, that's what I meant to say. And the central axis, the head. Now, the hips and the shoulders are difficult to focus on in the beginning. And the hands and the feet as well, because there is too much movement. The shoulders and the hips, too little movement. Hands and feet, too much movement. So we focus on the center, the elbows, and the knees. We're going to do the same exercise. So you focus on the shoulder disc rotation, but be aware of the elbow. And now one rule applies. So when the elbow moves, the knee moves. When the knee moves, the elbow moves. When one of the two stops, the other one stops as well. Of course, we start with bent legs. We sit on our tail. Don't sit too low. Just relax so that the back can straighten and so on. Hands on the tabletop. That means that if I start this rotation, the elbow moves. The hand is on the tabletop, stays on its place. It can rotate a bit. It can shift sideways, but it does not leave the table. So it's glued. So the elbow moves forward. Now, if the elbow moves, rotation, elbow move, knee move. Like that. Focus the legs. And then, same, so I bounce back with the shoulder disc, but then again, the elbow move, elbows move, so the knees move, hands move up, release them from the table, and then you relax from the elbow down towards the palms. So the shoulder disc rotation sets a lot in motion because the elbows move, therefore the knees move. Of course, the palm base leaves the table, the fingertips are still on the table. Now I bounce back with the shoulder disc, so the elbows move again. But the knees as well. One of the two will stop. In this case, the knees are more likely to stop before the elbows stop. And there you relax the elbows towards the palms. The arms just fall down on the table. So shoulder disc, elbows and knees. Here the elbows are most likely to stop first, unless you stood in a higher position than I did. It doesn't matter which one stops first. As long as you are aware of one of the two stopping its move, so the other one does as well. Shoulder disc bounces back, so the elbows move downward, the hands move up, but the knees move with the elbows. There, relax through the elbows towards the palms. So there you go. There, and relax. Now, we're going to repeat this exercise a few times because it's a really important awareness and even a movement habit to develop. But, we're going to add some Qigong to it. And how do we do that? Well, as soon as we release the elbow, there we've sunk. The knees have stopped moving, the elbows have stopped moving, and you release the elbow. You feel imaginary water flowing out through the palm. At the same time, you relax through the legs into the floor again. Now you're working on the mechanics. The shoulder disc rotates forward, elbows stop, knees stop, bounce back, elbows and knees move at the same time. Here, one of the two was at the sense of movement, so the other one stopped as well. Now I relax through the elbow towards the palm, through the legs, don't mind, worry about the starting point, just through the legs to the feet. So rotate, elbows and knees move. Bounce the rotation. Elbows and knees move, stop at the same time, and go. Shoulder disc rotation, elbows and knees move. Elbows and knees move. And relax. Good. This is what we're going to work with. In Tai Chi, the basic idea of moving is what they call Kai He. Kai, opening, dispersing actually, and He, bringing back together. Sometimes translated as closing, but that has a wrong association in our language. Just bring things back together. So you spread out from the center to the extremities. What are the extremities? The five palms, the soles of the feet, palms of the hands, and the top of the head being a palm as well. So from the center, you spread out to the five palms, and from the five palms, you revert towards the center. Now in Tai Chi, because it's a moving art, there is always one leg that does not take part in this well, expansion. So what you get is, if you follow my movement, I'm sitting on this leg. Of course, there's a lot of support on that leg. They call this a Sulio Puga 6-4 position, meaning 60%, 40%. But this is actually the Baucho position. Now, this knee and this elbow, because this arm is already at its proper height. So, don't worry now about the shoulder dislocation, it will happen all by itself. Just align this movement with that movement. So, there, and when one stops, the other stops. Now my leg is fully stretched, it's not overstretched, the knee is not being pushed backward, but it's fully stretched. So I can still sink a bit. Sinking is done by relaxing the hip joints, if possible, inside of the hip joints, the groin if you like, and then through the inside of both legs to the floor. Of course, this leg will have more weight than that leg, but you want to sink equally, wedge-like. So once moved up there, now I relax here. And there, the arms, that's where I sink. To the feet, from the knees down to the feet, and from the elbows to the palms, and this part to the top of the head. So let's repeat, just fall back. Again, when I fall back, this knee, that elbow, there. To its fullest, and sink. Move out through the arms to the palms, up through the neck, the head, the top of the head, and down through the legs, through the soles of the feet. One more on this side, just sink. Move up. Position. There. Let's shift sides. Now when I rotate, knee, elbow. So that down there, the connection, elbow, knee connection switches in the leg part. I was standing here, I rotate that ball. Elbow knee, there. Still on the same side, elbow knee. And now I switch. Up. When one of the two stops, elbow or knee, the other one stops as well. And then you release. So knee, elbow. There. Up. Position. Adjust. Turn. Elbow knee on that side. Same side. Switch sides. Move only with one arm. The other one stays still. Up. Down. Up. One more on this side. And one more. Short series on the other side. Sink. Knee, elbow. This arm just stays in place. One of the two stops, my knee stops. And sink. Pull down. Do not release your arm too much like that. There's always a roundness. Up. Position. and center. Okay, shake the leg a bit to relax our tremendous muscles. Their leg. How do you connect the elbow and the knee movement? In the previous loose exercise with the table, it was because of the shoulder disc rotation. Now I said, don't pay attention to that, just pay attention to the elbow and the knee moving at the same time. Connect them through the back. Like if you stand, let's say like this, what I'm doing now is I'm rounding my back. Not pushing this out, I'm just trying to feel how I fit in a turtle shell. The top of my head, then the top side of my back, of course, the soft part of my back, and the outside of my upper legs, and the outside of my arms. And I'm trying to fit myself into a turtle shell. And you will find a position where you think for yourself, okay, this is where I feel that. Again, there is no physical correctness. I can't say that you are wrong if you're standing different than I am, because I can't register what you are feeling. And now you have this. One knee, one arm. Pause. So you get this. Try to stay inside the turtle shell. There. One knee, one elbow, same side. Pull back. Shift sides. Other knee, other elbow. Move them at the same time. And fall back. There. And that's the mechanical part. An idea added to it, the turtle shell idea. Now we're going to swap. So you position yourself inside the turtle shell, like this, more or less like this. Don't be too precise about that. You have the idea, okay, now I'm standing with my back and the outside of my arms and upper legs and the back of my head, pressing against the turtle shell with the entire surface, and that's fine. But now it's not you making the movement, it's the turtle shell opening up and folding back, and opening up and folding back. And that's where it becomes difficult. You try to stay glued, as it were, to the turtle shell, but if the turtle shell moves, there we go. Search for the turtle shell. And now the turtle shell actually is rounded. I'm glued against the turtle shell and the turtle shell opens cross-like, diagonally, like that. The other side. This is difficult. It's the turtle shell opening, I'm still sticking to it, and it's folding back. Both sides at the same time, then you get the turtle shell unfolding and folding back. Now you're actually pulling the turtle shell over your back and outside. Like so. Like so. Good. Open up.